There aren't many places in the world you can slap an air bottle on your back, go down 30 feet or so, and watch the sharks go by. In fact, just about the only place you can do it with some hope of living to tell the story is in the Red Sea off Ras Mohammed, the southernmost tip of the Sinai. And even here, divers are afraid they might not be able to do it much longer. The sharks living off the coral reefs here are among the most accessible in the world to scientists, to photographers, to intrepid divers. Up until now, at least, they've been very friendly. But this whole area, all of the Sinai, is in the midst of a political transition right now, and believe it or not, the sharks are caught up in it. For the last 12 years, the sharks have been swimming in Israeli waters. They're about to become Egyptian. Anwar Sadat is gradually regaining control of the entire desert and its territorial waters. Israel is giving up what it conquered by force and what it learned to love and protect. The Israeli occupation may have been controversial politically, but ecologically it was a masterpiece. The Israelis set up nature reserves. They passed and enforced tough legislation protecting wildlife on the sands and in the sea. As Americans were instrumental in orchestrating the peace between Egypt and Israel, Americans are getting involved now in pressing for continued conservation, particularly of the magnificent coral reefs off Ras Mohammed. Marine biologist Dr. Eugenia Clark, professor of zoology at the University of Maryland, is spearheading a campaign aimed at convincing Sadat that what he's getting under these waters is worth taking care of.
The Egyptians don't have a conservation program developed yet. They are very much aware of the problem, and they're starting to develop it, but they're like just infants in this field, and the Israelis have really worked out all the problems. They don't allow spearfishing, they don't allow any abuse of the reefs and marine life, because people come out here and they think each person wants to take back one shell, one piece of coral, one shell. They think, what harm is that? But when you get thousands of people coming to one area and picking off the prettiest shells and corals, you have nothing left in no time. I think it's the most beautiful place in the whole world.
Dr. Clark went to Cairo recently to take her case to the president. Sadat responded by sending a small team of Egyptian officials, scientists, and scholars to Ras Mohammed, the first such trip made overland in almost 25 years. They were subjected to 3 days of well-intentioned Israeli propaganda on how they, the Egyptians, should take care of their land and their waters. There was a hike through granite mountains which plunge right down to the sea. There was a cruise through the Straits of Tiran, where Egyptian guns once threatened Israeli shipping and triggered 2 wars. It was a quiet exercise in normalization, diving diplomacy. The message from Israelis to Egyptians, if you don't control and restrict developers, fishermen, tourists, and divers, the incredible underwater world here can disappear within a few months. And Dr. Clark warned that among the first to leave would be the sharks.
Wherever you have a lot of divers, or especially divers with spearfishing, you don't find sharks anymore. And sharks are still, they're such beautiful creatures. Everybody gets a big kick and a thrill out of seeing sharks.
David and Anne Dubelet go into shark-infested waters the way some people hop on a commuter train or drive to the office. The Dubelets are contract photographers for the National Geographic. They're here with Dr. Clark to do a photographic essay on sharks. The Dubelets have shot more than a dozen underwater stories for the Geographic, but for them there's no place like Ras Mohammed and no subject like a shark.
I've always been totally fascinated with sharks. I think they have a kind of a mythical quality. A shark is a kind of a combination of a machine and an animal. Very few animals that look like jet planes yet have eyes, and the eyes are cold and dark and almost without feeling.
Well, I think that there's a lot of bad press for sharks right now, if you will, and I feel very warmly towards them, as a matter of fact. I feel that they're my friends. We've been diving with them now for 2 weeks straight and seen them in groups of 10 to 12 on every dive, and it seems that each day we can get, they get more and more used to our presence, and they come in closer and closer to the lens. And
slowly they'll come toward us, and very slowly then suddenly there is something out there, excuse me. Stop for a second.
Dolphin.
That's not a dolphin.
No.
That is not a dolphin. Slow up. There's a big fin following us, and it's not a dolphin.
Like any world leader, Anwar Sadat receives a lot of petitions, hears a lot of pleas. This is one he probably hasn't heard before. Save the sharks. Bob Simon, CBS News, in the Red Sea.